Hello students, once again welcome back to the class of physics. So in this session actually we started to discuss the concept of optoelectronic devices. In that we studied what is photodiode as well as we studied only photodiode. So the next one is LED. So LED means what? It is nothing but it's a light emitting diode. So light emitting diode, so as the name itself says that it will emit light, one, or we can say, in other words, this is a diode which converts electrical energy into light energy. It means it will convert electrical energy into light energy. So this is what we can call it as light emitting diode. So this will works under forward bias condition. Forward bias PN junction diode. Forward bias PN junction diode. So where actually, what is the symbolic representation, sir? Same, similar. So this PN junction diode only. So we can show like this. It will produces a light. Okay. So how it is going to produce? See, it is a device, hope you all know that in all decoration purpose we are using this LED lights. So what is the purpose of using LEDs? Because it consumes low power, very less power it consumes, hence we are going to get the desired output, so than that of any other lights. Okay, that too depends on the color. So for different colors it has different voltage. Okay, so if you, for red, let us take for red, it consumes more voltage. Okay, for blue and all, it consumes less voltage. So this is how it goes actually. So this is a device in generally which is works under forward bias condition, and we are using this device to convert electrical energy into light energy. So this LED consists of a chip of semiconductor diode which is added with some impurities, which is added with some impurities, and it is a chip of semiconductor diode. So this semiconductor diode, the charge carriers are generated when the electric current is passed through it. So when the electric current is passed through this particular diode, then what happens? The charge carriers will be generated at the junction of the diode. So what happens when it is forward biased? We know that actually it is conducts, correct? So when a given circuit or anything you take, if it is our diode, if it is forward bias, what is the meaning of this? It will conduct. So then what happens? If it is under forward bias, we can say the electrons from the N side, they'll move to the P side, and the hole from the P side, they'll move to the N side. Then what happens? This will constitute a current. Okay, so because of this, what happens? We are going to get the current. So what happens? There is a junction which is created. So the number of electron hole pair or combination that we can observe at the junction of, around the PN junction generally, sorry. At the PN junction surrounding, we are going to get electron hole pair. So there, it will constitute a current. If it is the, depends on the width of the depletion region. So if the width of the depletion region is goes on increases, then what happens? The current, what you are going to get, it is very less. And initially we are going to get the current because of the minority charge carriers which are already present over there in the P side as well as in the N side. So because of this minority charge carriers, what happens? They obviously combine near the junction. Because of that only you are going to get the current. So when this combination is takes place, so electron hole, so what happens, they will they combine at the junction of the p-n junction diode or semi p-n junction semiconductor diode. These two will combine and these two will constitute some energy that is released in the form of photons. So that is released in the form of photons. Photons are nothing but what? They are the sources of energy. Okay, light energy. Okay, photons are nothing but what? The energy which we are getting because of light. So similarly, because of this electron hole combination, which is produced at the junction of the semiconductor diode, so they will attain, they will produces some kind of energy. So that energy released in the form of photons. So this photons energy is equals to the intensity of light emitted. So not equals, actually it is little small compared to that intensity. So that is the reason why we are going to get the light there. So what happens when you increase the forward bias current, then what happens, the intensity of light also goes on increases. When you increase the intensity, sorry, forward bias voltage, so the current also goes on increases. Similarly, the intensity of incident light is also goes on increases. There you are going to get the bright colored light. So when you decrease the voltage, dim. So when you increase the voltage, the bright color light you are going to get in case of LEDs. So this is what the another application of optoelectro, so the special purpose of semiconductor diode. In that, another one is what? LED. So that is light emitting diode. So it is very, very important. So usually they will ask one out of three in your exam. So we have another one, that is solar cell, that we will see next. So what do you mean by solar cell? So as the name itself says, solar cell, it is a device which is used to convert light energy into electrical energy. So reverse of LED. So solar energy into electrical energy in general, that is solar cell. I forgot to mention the application of this LED, where and all we are using this LED. And in TVs, LED circuit, VCRs, everywhere we are using this. And where in TV remotes, for off and on purpose, decoration purpose, and in signals. So there, everywhere we are using this LED lights. Okay, and calculator, for in generally the measuring instruments. For example, digital meters usually. So there we are using this LEDs. And what is the advantage, sir? Users is different. Advantage, why we need to use this LEDs even though we have some other lights? So because it has very less operational voltage and as well as it consumes very less current. Similarly, it has fast on and off ability. If we do like that, we can save energy. Or else if you take some other lights, it will take some time to off. Or it will take some time, is not in terms of hours, like just a seconds or milliseconds it will take. But in microseconds, this LED lights will start on and we can do off. And also it consumes less power, and the heating of LEDs usually it is not so much as compared to other lights, so it will not get heated up. So the life of LED is very high than compared to any other lights. Okay, and So the light emitted is nearly monochromatic. So single color light we are going to get here in this case. And as I told you, it has a long life than compared to any other lights. So if you take other lights, what they are using in your home appliances, in your house. So when compared to that particular lights, this LED lights will give a long life. So we can use it for a month or maybe a year, like that you can use. So this is what actually the application or advantages of this LED light. So the next one is photovoltaic cell, or we can say in other words, solar cell. So what is photovoltaic cell or solar cell? So there's a diagram in your book. Just go through with the diagram. So we have a region like this is a solar cell they kept over here like this, and this is N region, this is a P region, they have coated something over here. So I'll tell you what is the purpose of using this. So light will come and fall on this particular solar cell. So solar cell is basically PN junction which will produce voltage, or we can say EMF or electrical energy that we are going to get because of that solar cell. When the radiation falls on the PN junction, so it's a PN junction diode. When the radiation falls on the PN junction diode, so this is a top surface. Hope you all know that we are using, we have a solar energy, solar plant where near to this pagoda, there you can observe. What is the purpose of using that? Because in that solar plant, what they are using is the light is made to fall on the solar cell. Because of that, we are going to produce enormous enough amount of electrical energy. Okay, so not only electrical energy, we can convert that into heat energy also. So many more applications are there. Here in generally, solar cell is used to convert the incident light energy into solar energy into electrical energy. It's a kind of the PN junction diode is also used over here. It is also works on the same principle of photodiode. What is the principle of this one? Solar cell is, it is works on the same principle of photodiode. So what is the principle? You know that it works on the reverse bias condition. Okay. So it, but the difference is what, sir? See here, we are not going to connect you any, no external battery, no external battery. That means no external support for this particular solar cell. So it can convert directly. So incident light energy into electrical energy. So what happens when a light of suitable frequency, suitable frequency, why? Because in general we can say threshold frequency means what? So the minimum frequency requires to remove an electron from the metal surface, then only it will conduct, right? So here also the same thing, because the frequency of incident light is less than that of the threshold frequency of this particular solar cell what we have taken, or we can say the energy gap which is there inside the semiconductor diode, no? If it is less than that, the incident energy, light energy, is less than that of the EG, that is energy gap. So then what happens? Obviously, it will not conduct. So that's the reason why they use this particular word. The frequency also. What is the relation? That is E is equals to H nu. So nu is important here. So H is nothing but what? It's a Planck's constant that we already know. We studied that concept in the chapter Dual Nature of Radiation and Matter. So no problem there. But here you have to understand, it depends on, energy depends on what? The incident light frequency. So if that frequency of incident light must be stronger than to emit an electron from the metal surface. If it is like that, then only we are going to get the desired output. So what happens, because of this light which is incident on the solar cell, it will emits an electron. So that electron will produces what, a EMF or voltage. So because of that, we are going to get the electrical energy, and we have to do some other process also, which is there inside the solar panels. Okay, so that is all not required here. Just write this much: what is the purpose of using solar cell? It is used to convert a suitable solar energy or light energy into electrical energy. So this is all about the solar cell. And what is the advantages, where actually the solar cells are used? So actually solar cells are used in power electronic devices, in artificial satellites, space satellites. Why, sir? Because when we send a satellite to the particular orbit, if you want to send, so what happens, it's need an energy, correct? So there we are not going to put fuel all the time. So what we need to do, we are using this solar energy. We are going to keep the solar panel over the spaceships. So from there, when the light is incident on it, then what happens, it will consume some amount of energy, solar energy, then it will convert it into electrical energy. So for that they can move, and we can send a satellite to that particular orbit. Meanwhile, we have external source, additional source, but additional to that, we are using this solar panels, because it consumes some electrical energy, because to operate inside the satellite stations, so for that satellite we need a certain amount of electrical energy. So that can be, that it can get it from the light. So that's the reason why they are using in satellites and all, or in generally spaceships or space vehicles. And also, in order to provide the supply power for calculators. So now we have a calculators. So when we keep the calculator, or when we expose it to sunlight, then what happens, it will get charged, then we are going to use it. We can use it without even external battery or shells, what we can say, shells. Even though if it is no, it doesn't have the shells or battery, we can use it. So we need to expose that calculator to the sunlight, then we can use it. And then also, so in order to supply power to homes in remote places, see, that is the thing. So when you take some other remote places where you can't keep electric poles, so it is not possible to send the electrical energy, so for that, what they'll do, they'll keep few solar panels around their houses, and they'll generate their own electrical energy because of this sunlight. Or by using the solar cell or solar energy, we are going to get the electrical energy that can be utilized for their home appliances, to run the home appliances. It is more than enough to generate the electrical energy. Okay, so this is all about the chapter of semiconductor diode. So from here we are done with the chapter. Just go through with the last concept, in that Zener diode and photodiode, LEDs and solar cells. So these are very, very important. So out of four, one day definitely they'll ask in your exam. So just go through with that. If you have any doubt, just post your doubts in the group, then we will discuss.